Good morning, everyone. Thanks for watching News to Go. Get the umbrella handy. You'll need it today. Showers are moving in. Once they arrive, they'll be around for the better part of the afternoon, certainly into the evening, and we may even pick up a couple of thunderstorms with that. A few could be severe. Temperatures this morning are in the 60s for everybody. Highs will be in the 70s. Bear in mind, whether you're in Northwest Arkansas or the River Valley, if you do get those passing thunderstorms that become severe, we've got to be looking out for gusty winds, hail, or possibly even isolated tornadoes. Again, highs today in the low to mid 70s. Good news is we'll get some sunshine and a beautiful weekend in store. Daniel.
Thank you, Laura. A dangerous animal ordinance geared to keep people safe failed to pass. This after a dog attacked a cyclist last month. Now, the emergency measure would have tightened Washington County's dangerous animal laws. It needed 10 votes to pass, but only got 6 at Tuesday night's meeting. Members debated the issue for 2.5 hours. And this morning, police are looking for a man they say is armed and dangerous. The Sebastian County Sheriff's Office says this man is accused of taping a woman to a chair. Authorities say it happened Tuesday morning in Midland. They say that the suspect and 2 others got away with guns. They were last seen driving a dark gray or blue pickup truck. Well, students at the University of Arkansas at Fort Smith are just months away from walking across the stage. But before they can do that, they have to go to Grad Fest first. 4020 Nights, Pedro Rivera on campus with more.
The University of Arkansas at Fort Smith really wanted to make this a celebration for the students and their accomplishments. So this year they added popcorn, door prizes, and music to make GradFest really a celebration. It's all going to be happening right over here in the Smith Pendergraph Campus Center. Now, for all the students, it's a one-stop graduation stop. Students will get an opportunity to snap a cap and gown picture, grab an alumni t-shirt, but more importantly, get prepared for life after college. There's going to be some resume building courses, also getting students set up on their online job posting site. Now, one of the things they added this year is a what's next table. So they really want to know what you're doing after college, whether it's grad school, going abroad, or you have a really cool job. Let them know. There's going to be 2 sessions today, from 10 to 1 or from 3 to 6 in Fort Smith. Pedro Rivera, 4029 News.
More than 660 students are expected to graduate. And that's your News to Go. I'm Daniel Armbruster. Have a great Wednesday.